the swan can't bother my lines. Okay. Tight down to that bank. Doesn't matter how close that bird gets. That line is going. That's the way I have it. In fact, I need to move that right hand rod back an inch. So, usual spots in this little area here. The bait that was in 2 days ago is now gone. I came back. I was down here yesterday morning. Yesterday morning was Sunday morning. That was the first chance that I'd got to have a session since Friday. The last time I put bait in here was Thursday, when I put half a kilo in. And I came down here on a Friday night and I had that 20. I'm baiting up another spot further down the river at the moment, which is where I've seen the carp frequent. I've just gone and had a look at the baited area. I'm pretty sure some of the bait has gone, although it's difficult to see with the light levels the way they are. It's beautifully overcast, as you can see. we've had the two hottest days of the year. Today it was the hottest day of the year, it was in the 30s. Hence the attire. So I come straight from work, I've missed dinner and all that, just come straight from work, it's about 6 o'clock. Got a half packet of biscuits with me and a bottle of water. That'll do me for the next couple of 3 hours, which is all the time I'm going to be here. And then I'm going to go. I'm not going to put any bait in this swim before I go. I'm just going to fish this spot out, basically. I've stopped putting bait in here because obviously it's known about. But as much as anything else, I want to try and start catching the fish elsewhere, because once a spot starts to blow, I have found that if you get another one going nearby on the same bait, you can start catching again. So yeah, I think this spot might have blown a little bit, but I'm going to keep fishing it for the next couple of 3 sessions this week, and see how it goes. You know, if there's any fish to be nicked off of this, then I want to try and get them. And then I'll move up river to the other spot. I've got a couple of kilos of bait with me, which is all going to go on the spot that I'm baiting up tonight. It had 2 kilos last night, a kilo on each spot in the area that I'm fishing. I'm going to go back to that area tonight on my way back home in a couple of 3 hours and put another kilo on each of those spots. So you can see the amount of effort and time and work. I was down here on Sunday, and I was walking up and down this bank, all the way in the wood there, all the way along here, all the way up there. I also cycled all the way along the other side of the bank and round into the other meadows that I can get into down there. So I did the whole sort of two mile or so stretch here, up to where I live. I've still got another area which is a really good area which I haven't started baiting yet, and I'm going to be doing that soon. We'll see how the spot 2 does. But like I say, spot 1 here, pretty much blown out now, I think, but you never know. It would be nice to get that 30 again and see if it weighs any more than it did when I caught it. So yeah, obviously there's going to be nomadic fish that we can pick up as well that are not part of the pod that I'm after. There's a little group of fish, there's about 7 of them. The linear is the one that I want. Once I catch the linear, I'll be happy to move elsewhere then. But that's the fish that I want. I saw it yesterday, I was a couple of feet from it, I was a couple of feet from 30. And I estimated it to be mid-20s, so we will see. Well, 7 o'clock-ish, so we've been here a good hour now. I've been standing up against the wall there a little bit now and again, haven't spotted any fish moving in the swim. The way I'm feeling at the moment, I could give it another couple of hours and I reckon that would be enough. It could be that the magic spot, magic time is just before dark, just after dark. But you know, I've got to have dinner and all sorts of stuff's got to be done. I can't get done during the day, so I've got to balance your life out a little bit, I guess. I've decided not to bait up the second spot tonight because there's bait left on it earlier. I don't know how much, but there was some, so I'm going to wait until all that bait is gone before I bait it again. That way there won't be any too much bait laying around, not getting eaten, which is good. So yeah, I'm just going to hold back on that basically tonight. I'm still not going to put any in here before I leave though. Even though I think this is a better spot, I think it would be more fished out, and I reckon that next one could produce, certainly a left out. Yes, I have to say I do want to catch a fish, but I've gone from expecting to catch one to not expecting to catch one from this spot. I can remember, gosh, not long into carp fishing, realising that swims blow, spots blow. You know, you get the hot swims on a lake. On most lakes, certain swims are always the hottest swims. And it's the same on rivers. And then, you know, you find that they get fished, and the more they get fished, the harder it becomes to catch fish from them, until you can't catch fish from them at all. And this is a combination of fish being very wary when they're in the area, simply avoiding the area, or simply avoiding picking up any baits when they're in the area. Or, you know, but, so that's why you have to move around. I find that areas, spots, blow quicker than a bait does. But I find fish will return to a spot and a bait time and time again. If it's a good spot and if it's a good bait, they'll always eat it. I've put so much ghost in this river now. I've put in over 20 kilos in the last couple of 3 weeks. I've put in so much, they're on it. They're like almost addicted. So when they come across it, they're going to eat it. They're expecting it. Will they associate the bait with being caught? I don't know. They might associate the area far more at the moment than the bait, because the bait's been going in various areas, not just where they've been getting caught. So, you know, hopefully that's how I work with the carp and they'll think like that. So there was a few more to come from upriver. I don't know. Yeah, there seems to be a lot of ladies out tonight. It's a lovely warm summer's evening. There's loads of ladies out on the river. I might get myself a nice big fat lady. Yeah, it'd be interesting to catch that big one again though, that big river. See what it weighs, see if it's putting on weight through spawn or if it's lost any weight, etc. But I think that fish could carry a lot more weight, definitely. Could go up a 30s. Nice to see one of those tips bouncing up and down. Bobbin's bouncing up and down too. How about that? You get all sorts along the towpaths, I tell you. Check it out. We just had a minor crash over here. One pretty young girl with two pretty young girls. Four pretty young girls nearly. There we go. We've got a mixed pair coming along here. As you can see, it's right over the swim. Oh no, not mixed pair. A pretty pair. I have to say, it's been getting really busy with the boats, but they're all so good looking. You know, they're all great big blokes, it would be so much fun. And like I say, I keep reminding myself the carp don't care, because I've sandwiched these carp loads of times in this river over the years. And all other fish as well, chub especially, and they don't care about the boats. Occasionally they might get out of the way of an oar if they're close, but you know, from what I saw. So the time is, according to my mobile, 20 past 7. Ooh, we've got a message from Mr. Spencer. So, yeah, we're going to give it another hour or so, I reckon. I don't know how busy it is with the boats, but definitely going to give it another hour. And then tomorrow night, just going to come down, bait up spot 2, have a look at this spot here, hang around a little bit, have a look-see, and that's it. And then back Wednesday night to fish this spot again, and possibly bait up spot 2. And then Thursday night, bait up spot 2, Friday night, fish this spot again, or possibly the first spot, depending on how things are going. I do think I can still nick a few wandering fish off of this spot though. It's still a good area to catch fish from, you know, whatever bait you're using really. So if the spot 2's not going, it's, you know, this is the spot I'll stick on. I'll stay on this one. I mean, I'm putting a little bit of bait in it, albeit only 20 or 30 when I come fishing. Still being picked up by the carp, I'm pretty sure about that. This is the young lady that had the accident. It all happened rather suddenly. But no one was hurt. And here comes the 8-man crew that went the other way. Right over the swim, look at that. Oh, listen to it. That one's just the most ragtag crew you'll ever see on the cam. I don't think they're one of the university crews, because it's a mixed crew, and they're rocking all over the place. I mean, look at them, they're absolutely a mess. Compared to the university crews, of course. I mean, I'm no expert. Christ, I'd be as bad as they are. Worse, in fact. So we've got a little bit of peace and quiet. We've got one 8-man crew gone down river, and I think another 4 and a 2-man. And I think there's a 1 or a 2-man coming this way now. So it's quite busy. Masses and masses and masses of roach over the swim. I don't know if you can see them, but the water is black with roach at the moment. The cam has got loads in. Absolutely loads. It's full to the brim with roach. But all the pike have been caught and eaten. Apparently. So yeah, we're in a busy period at the moment, but it might get quieter in a little while. I mean, this is about an hour or so after dinner, so, you know, they'll get out for about an hour or so, and hopefully it'll quieten down. So we've got about an hour's fishing left. And then I call it a day, because I'm really hungry. I've got a good dinner yet. Just gone 8 o'clock, so I'm going to give it another half an hour. Some won't be down for another hour, but I'm starving. Stuff to do. I'll be back down tomorrow, so I'll check the spot, see if the bait's gone. And I'll be down at bait up, of course, spot 2 if it needs it. Hopefully it will. So we're back to sort of finding them and feeding them and getting them going mode again. which was what we were in just before the start of the season, the fishing season, a week or so before, in fact, because the week leading up to it, we really had them going, and I was putting in 1-2 kilos of bait a day, and they were having it all. Incredible amount of bait they were scoffing. So, yeah. So we might get a fish in the next half hour, and there's a good chance, like I say, if I stayed until dark, I might get one, but I'm limited on time, and I'm going to stick to what I do. I'm not going to push it, I'm not going to overdo it. There's no point in that. So yeah, so I'll come back tomorrow, I'll have a look, see if the bait's gone, bait up spot next door, and then back on Wednesday to fish this spot again, probably, possibly bait up spot 2, and then bait up spot 2 Thursday, if it needs it, and fish Friday. Butcher. So here we are, it's about 20 past 3, Wednesday evening. Got off work early, nice, got tomorrow off as well. Seeing Gary tomorrow, coming down and baiting up. I've just been to visit the second area and have a look at the spots. As far as I can see, the bait that was visible is possibly gone, but the water's got a bit of colour in it. Show you. Can't actually see it, but you can't see the bottom very well at all, which is always nice. They make mistakes far more in coloured water. Also, coloured water gets them feeding. Now, we've had thunderstorm yesterday, rain overnight, and that's what's helped with the colour in the water. So I've got some sandwiches with me, so I'm here until about 7 or 8, hopefully, and with any luck, we'll have one out before we go. It'd be nice to get 2, wouldn't it? It'd be nice to get some strangers as well, not any that we've caught already. As far as I can tell, the bait that I put in the swim the last few nights that I fished it, it's all gone. Saturday morning session, Monday morning session, the bait is gone. So I'm pretty sure carp are still moving through here and feeding. As you can tell, it's getting up to rush hour, so it's pretty busy above our heads. I don't know how busy it is on the river. Probably won't get too busy until about 6 or 7. We'll see how I've done. Talking of which, straight over the swim, look, them oars, straight in the swim. So we've had a couple of blank sessions in this swim now. When I say blank sessions, we're only talking about 2-3 hours maximum. So real short sessions, but at a time when I would expect to catch fish. So, you know, I think it's about a group of about 7 fish. This is what I've spotted before the close season. I've now counted for each fish, and I'm recognising fish in the water that I've caught as well. For instance, I saw the 30, I saw the ghosty type common. It looks orangish. It's got orange in it. See in the water, it looks fabulous in the water, it really does. And literally within 2 feet of me, I could have reached out and touched these fish. That's how close they were to me, sunning themselves the other day when it was really, really hot. So I've seen the fish loads, I know where they get, I know what they're up to. So, you know, I've caught 4 of them, so there should be about 3 more to catch. But of course, you're going to get fish passing through, nomadic fish. I mean, I've caught over 12 other carp from here. I've not caught this year, so they're still to catch, and that was 7 years ago, 2004, so they could all be good 20s by now, especially the doubles, and that 20 that I caught could easily be a 30, so, you know, there's lots of potential in the cam, but they're spread out, and there's not too many of them, so finding them and then constantly feeding them every single day, if necessary, but constantly keeping feed going in that swim is vital importance to you succeeding. You've got to get those fish coming in that swim all the time looking for food and hanging around in the area. They don't come cheap. don't come easy some days, you just don't want to come down, you know. So, there you go. This is not the nicest place in the world to fish, you know, when you think about it, is it? But the carp are here, you know. I found the carps milling around here and I fed them and held them here. And I'm sure that they're hanging around here longer than they probably normally would, perhaps, because of all the bait. I've put in over 20 kilos in this area and the other area and a few other little spots since 3 weeks ago. I'm probably nearer 25 kilos and I'm running out. I'm down at my last couple of kilos. Thankfully, Gary will be coming along tomorrow with some more. Okay. Well, the time's coming up to 6:30. I reckon I'll put up with this for about another hour before I need to get home and get some food in the car. I think this spot is definitely quiet down, hasn't it? I think if I'd be putting bait in here, it'd probably fire up again, but because I'm putting bait in the other area, I think I'll just leave the spot alone. So this is probably the last time I'm fishing here as well, before I move on to the second area. Because I'll be on that Friday. So we'll see how it goes on Friday. I'm pretty sure the bait's going, but well, I'll do a session on it soon though, because if I catch a fish straight away, then I'll really know they're on it, of course, which normally, you know, that's how it seems to go. You get couple of three fish, real quick fish, and then it can die. So yeah, I've only got a couple of three fish to catch. Hopefully I'll get that linear straight away. That'd be nice. It'd be nice to get it here as well, actually.